When I heard that Ben Lovett was going to do the music, I got very excited.
Because this film has so little dialogue, the sparseness of it creates so much room for the score. So I think Ben really had full rein to create whatever he wanted.
I often have the benefit of a lot of other people's hard work by the time I get started. From the writing to the production design to the performances, there was just a lot there for me to dive into for inspiration.
With a story like this, the wind and the score are going to play such a monumental role in speaking on behalf of Lizzie and what she's going through, because we don't hear her thoughts, we just experience them with her.
I think the score was really pivotal in terms of supporting our key character's state of mind, but I also think that the silence and the sound design of the wind was equally important.
The challenge was to figure out how to establish a consistent presence of wind without just filling every scene with sound effects.
I think the other heavy lifting that we felt like the score needed to do was create the sound of the demonic forces that were on the prairie. And a lot of the instruments began to amplify what the demon sounded like.
One of the earliest conversations I had with the director was, how might we embody that feeling in the score? And that led me to Sarah Anden and the bass flute.
The bass flute was so versatile and so perfect for this film. It is just so special to get it into any kind of film score, because there you can use a lot of subtle effects that it could do, as well as beautiful, lush melodies. So I'm singing while playing in the instrument, and I'm purposely going slightly out of tune. So it's creating a lot of dissonance that is very spooky.
It felt like we were listening to organic sounds that we might hear in the environment of that prairie.
These clips of Sarah playing the bass flute excited me so much, because I was like, wow, if the wind could be musical, this is what it would translate through. And the fact that he was able to find an instrument that could dance so well with the sound of the wind was so exciting. It made my skin crawl.
The score features a couple of instruments that are not often employed in film music. The nickel harp really has this distinct tonal quality that seemed to connect with that sort of rough, handmade, tactile feel of the elements on screen. There's something naturally haunting about the sound of that instrument.
I think it was like a painting that you got to put music to in some ways.
The very first thing written for the movie was actually the opening theme.
I felt like we had found our score after hearing that.
And I think that became our compass for navigating our way through the rest of the score.
We hear that theme maybe four times at the most, and yet it holds the whole movie together. I think why the theme is so strong is that it does have really big space in between those big, bold string hits. And within that space, you're able to hear the wind and you're able to feel the silence and the isolation.
This land is funny, you know. It plays tricks on your mind.
There's so much room to play with sound. It was, a unique liberty.
There is something out there.
As a composer, my aim is always to try and add another layer to the conversation that the film is having, and that's what really makes it worth doing.
Because the amount of life and tension that that score brings, it just moves you in a way that is very special.